the Trump fantasy that every Mexican wants to live here. Not every Mexican wants to be a leaf blower for their lifetime. In fact, most Mexicans aspire to something a bit higher than that. You know, I mean, it's so weird, though, that suddenly everybody is like, all these, like, bohunk people out in, you know, the storage states, as I call them. Utah, Nevada, Montana, the Decoupage. These are just storage states. It's where they put nuclear waste and the you know, NSA headquarters. And you just use the storage. Send your old minks there. The cold storage. And, you know, they're not, they don't even need them. We should just lease them. They shouldn't even be partnering us. All the people that live there think, oh God, the Mexicans are coming. The Mexicans might give them a little culture. I mean, Jesus. Yeah, I'm just like flummoxed though, because we don't have an immigration problem. We do not have an immigration problem. I mean, we have the immigration problem that the people that immigrated and founded the country shouldn't have come here. But that's different. I mean, there is zero immigration problem. I think we should just take all the theory over here. You know? But in the storage states. I need to make a conscious effort not to experience a nostalgic feeling. I'm immune to such feelings. I'm not a nostalgic person. I can be very sentimental in the privacy of my home, but not on a page. I'm allergic to that. I just think it's kvash. You know, I think, like, we have so many of our feelings manufactured for us, you know? Like all this necroflower romanticism about the 70s, like the New York Times thing. I mean, I love it. They made New York. I got here in 1978. New York had been here for 300 years. I didn't make it. Don't blame me. No, the accessing things is difficult because the older you get, the less you remember. I don't believe that anybody remembers anything accurately. I think, because all my life people have been telling me, oh, you have a fantastic memory, and I know I don't. You know, I just remember things that other people would like to forget. And so when I bring it up, I say, you've got a good memory. But I don't feel like total recall is my métier. And there's a part in the book, and I did talk about myself. Here's something I can remember. I remember my cousin Richard in Augusta. And I remember being in the living room of the apartment of his mother, and I remember him teaching me chess. And the next time I saw chessboard, I had totally forgotten chess. That was even when I was like 6 years old or something, 7 years old. Looking back, the stuff that you remember is the stuff that hurt you, basically, or the stuff that, or not even that. Sometimes you just can't even figure out why you remember what you remember, but I do know this, because it wasn't just while writing the book. No two people remember the same thing. They just don't. I mean, if you read that book on Cookie Miller that came out earlier this year, or last year, this year, Edgewise, which is a wonderful book, but you know, it's done a bit like Edie of the Gene Stein book, where everybody's talking about this period when we were all taking so many drugs that, I mean, the idea that anybody can remember anything is kind of amazing. But we read these overlapping narratives about parties that everybody was at, but nobody remembers exactly where the parties were, when they were, who was there. Nobody remembers the same things at all. I kind of really liked the book because she left that in instead of trying to narrow it down to something real, because there is nothing real there. You know, it's like, yeah, something happened. All these people were in this room at the same time, and there was like, maybe something happened. And it was, he said that to her, no, they said that to him. Like that, I mean, it's like the whole book is like that. It's like a, it's a decoupage of defective memory. And, yeah, I had trouble access. I didn't, the things that are in there, I didn't have any trouble remembering them. But that's all I remember. I mean, I had to pad some things out, so. It's not all true. Why would I say it was all true? Nothing I say is all true. It's like, you know, somebody else can dispute it easily, right? I think it's true, but I might be wrong. Pretty close to the last time those things would happen. So, you know, you don't want to know about the stuff in the middle because it's banal. I mean, after you've had sex a few times, that's what sex is. After you transgress what you thought were your principles the first time, it's like, okay, that is a jump. The first time you did something that your parents would have had a heart attack with me. Okay, but you know, the rest of life is the accumulation of those kinds of violations of what you thought reality was supposed to be. And it's not so interesting. But the first time was interesting. The first time you wreck your car on the freeway, the first time that seemed to have a freshness to it that I couldn't attribute to my middle period.